Level up.
Yo, what you guys doing over here? Walking the streets all by yourself? Square up. Hey, Imp, get him. Yep, get him.
Steeler souls.
Oh my God. Hold up, bro. Can I do this? Oh my, come here. Come catch this. Boom. Hello, everybody. Welcome to my channel. If you know, my name's Jaxx. I like the view. I look outside. I see some dudes. What are the dudes doing? They're shaving their pubes.
What?
Yep, and we stopped there. But today we're playing Saints Row Get Out of Hell. Now, somehow, you might be like, how is this one of your favorite ones? So I have a weird history with Saints Row. I never played the first one. I played a little bit of the second one. But then Saints Row 3, I almost like 100%ed it, I'm pretty sure. Beat it multiple times. I played it so much. Saints Row 4 came out. I played it. I hated the story, but I loved the game. And then Saints Row Get Out of Hell, I don't even remember when I got it, but I think it was around the same time I got Saints Row 4, and I loved this game too. But don't forget I was a child, okay? Don't hurt me. Hey, we all have different opinions. I just kind of like mostly everything. You could throw Roblox Tetris in my face and I probably would like it. Like, the one thing I mainly remember about this game is this cutscene. Hold up, let me show you this fire cutscene, bro. Oh my God, this cutscene will forever give me shivers. Hey, where's she at? Boom! Stop playing with her. Watch this. Boom! What'd that say, FBI? Kenzie, give me a chance. I love algebra.
That scene was fire. That hyped me up when I was playing it.
Yeah, we're just gonna play a little bit of this and, you know, have some fun as we always do. No matter what game it is, bro. Tell me some of the worst games known to man and I'll play them and we'll have fun. Watch.
Once upon a time, in a faraway land, there lived a man so exceptional that the divine hosts of heaven and hell were forced to take note. A man dangerous enough to bring Satan to his knees.
Oh my God!
Selfless enough to make God himself raise an eyebrow. How did this come to pass? Well, it all began at a very special birthday
party. Look at Shandy.
Surprise!
What is all this?
It's your birthday, Kenzie.
So?
You've never been to a birthday party?
No.
Oh, like not even growing up?
I went to the school of the Americas since kindergarten. We didn't really do birthday parties.
But you celebrated Christmas?
I don't have to explain myself to you.
Oh, Kenzie, this is going to be so much fun. Xinjai made a cake. Jane Austen is here. We'll play some games.
What sort of games?
Oh my gosh, bro. Oh my God, bro, the memories, the nostalgia for me.
So you celebrate birthdays by trafficking with spirits?
It's spooky and fun.
It's a bunch of letters.
I don't.
It's tradition. Every slumber party has to involve a spirit board.
Slumber party?
How's it work?
You see this?
Ask it a question.
I don't.
The spirit of the board will reveal the answer.
How?
Yeah, someone pushes the pointy thing to wherever they want.
Wait. Can we go back to you and your slumber parties?
No time. All right. Everyone put their hands on the cursor.
Cursor. I feel the magic already.
All right. Will the president slash god emperor for life ever choose a partner to reign alongside them?
No.
Ooh, oh. Someone's getting married.
Oh, yeah.
Who will tame the president's wild heart?
I forgot.
What are you guys trying to spell?
I'm not moving it.
That's the spirit, Kinsey.
I'm serious.
I'm not moving it either.
Neither am I.
Jezebel? Who the fuck is...
I forgot about this, bruh.
Is that not normal?
Where'd you get the board?
I was going through Zinyak's artifact collection and found it there.
Who did it belong to?
Alistair Crowley?
Oh my...
Guys, I think it's laughing at us.
Fuck this. I think you're a smart enough piece of wood to see where this is going. Now, you ready to cooperate?
Bro.
That's more like it.
You think we can trust it?
It's not like we got a lot of options.
So what's the plan? We mount up and go in after the boss?
No, I do. No sense in what's left of humanity walking right into a death trap. Someone's gotta live to tell the story.
That's a stupid plan, Johnny.
I'm leaving you in charge.
Hell of a plan, Johnny.
Are you serious?
Are you kidding
Bro.
Me?
Bro, oh my.
To come back?
Yeah, I try not to sweat the details.
You need some.
I don't know why, this feels like an episode of a show.
Fine. All right, then. You know where my friend is?
I don't remember.
The spirit board opened up another portal and sent Johnny and Kinsey screaming into hell.
Oh, well, I remember this. I know what happened to your girlfriend, but like, come on. Look how kids you already put out the. That's why I messed with you.
Ultor and the Saints haven't been enemies in years. You really think he's responsible?
You don't know him like I do. The boss put him through a window for a reason.
The reason was the boss was kind of fucking crazy back then.
That's a fair point.
You know how much easier this would be if we just found a car?
You know how much easier this would be if you just gave me a second?
Bro, there's a car right there, bro. Calm down.
Hit me with the animation.
Yes, sir.
And how are we gonna find the Ultor building?
Biggest building down here. Giant Ultor sign on it.
Look at all the NPCs.
I'll buy that.
Oh my gosh, look at them. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm gonna be like literally fanboying the whole time. And everybody in the comments is gonna be like, this is the worst game known to man. And you like it for some reason. Tony, man, nostalgia is one hell of a drug. I'm telling you, I spent countless nights trying to 100% this game. Playing with friends, meeting so many people on this game in co-op mode.
Generally, I'm a misanthrope.
Okay. Hold up, where's my subtitles? Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't even think about subtitles. You know, the Saints Row games are just a big part of my life, man.
So this is hell. Not as bad as I thought.
It kind of reminds me of Steelport.
Oh my gosh.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna shoot him in the face unless he gives us the boss back.
What if Dean doesn't have the boss?
I'll probably still shoot him in the face.
Well, let's shoot him in the face. Oh my gosh, hell is hot. Bro, things are just randomly exploding. Hello.
Welcome to hell.
Shouldn't you have a receptionist?
Such is the plight of eternal damnation. I have a feeling you didn't come here to catch up. Let's talk in my office.
You thought she was cool, huh?
Not even death could stop the enterprising Vogel, who wasted no time in setting up an Ultor branch in the bowels of hell. Dane was eager to fill Johnny in on the ever-shifting politics of land rights in the underworld. But real estate mattered little to Johnny, who only cared where his friend was.
Hey, bro.
Where'd you put the president?
I've been trying to explain that I didn't take them.
Bullshit. You expect me to believe you just happened to be the first thing we see in hell?
Maybe it's just me, but your thank you sounds more like an accusation.
That's probably because he plans to kill you.
Okay. I get the trust issues. Can I show you something?
And this whole little thing, I don't know why I like, but it's nostalgia, gotta be. I like this so much.
More chaos and destruction than any other in human history. It was only natural that Satan would want them to marry his daughter. They needed a plan, and Johnny had one.
I'm gonna shoot the devil in the face.
Yep, good plan.
You might be skipping some details.
No, I said in the face.
I like the commitment, but you gotta find a way to get close enough to him in the first place.
When's the wedding? I'll just show up
and then you'll shoot him in the face. Sorry, but it's a little more complicated than that. These things are tied to the soul. You won't be able to enter without one.
Okay.
So how do we get one?
You get his attention. I know some places that are of particular value to the father of the bride. You hit those, you'll get your shot.
Wait, why would Satan give out an invitation for destroying his stuff?
It's hell.
We won't, but it should piss him off enough to get him to attack Johnny personally. Oh. Either the devil kills Gat and Ultor gets the construction contracts to rebuild what was destroyed, or Johnny kills Satan and I'll have to pay less taxes. It's pretty win-win.
That's why you're helping us? To make more money in hell?
Hell's what you make of it, sweetie.
Works for me. What you got?
All right.
This literally feels like a show.
Satan had entrusted the day-to-day running of
Hell. Okay, bro, let me play the game, babe, bro.
And Dane knew how to find
them
all.
Oh, God.
But beyond that, not everyone in Hell was content to go along with Satan's status quo. There were others who shared Dane's ambition for power. And the Altor mogul knew that the key to unseating Satan lay in gaining their aid. But before Johnny set out to wage war against the Prince of Darkness, Dane had one final gift, an artifact that he had spent fortunes on. Lucifer's cracked halo. This holy relic granted Johnny the majestic wings of the Morning Star. However, he still needed help in learning how to use them.
Oh my gosh, this tutorial. I don't know why I'm saying, oh my god, I'm going to need this tutorial.
All right, you got me out in the sticks, now what?
Would it kill you to show a little excitement? You're about to experience angelic flight, for Christ's sake.
Okay, bro.
Over here, boom, 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 flight. Cool, now you're out to the air, perfect, you can get an altitude, engage flight, hold steady, blah, 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 blah. Over here, go, yeah, super spin, blah, 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 blah.
And level up!
All right, let's start slow. Try to jump over Boop. To that next island. Also, the
oh my gosh, this is magnificent.
Jumping, the further you'll go. Hey, you didn't fuck it up. Good job. Now get up that cliff. Don't worry. If something looks too now it's
there's no. What's it called?
You heard of crawling before walking? Well, in this
isn't
case,
this
you need to jump before you can fly.
Wait, I s- oh, it's controlled by the mouse. Okay. Jump,
and then. Hold your wings out to
I swear it was inverted on Xbox.
Do that by pointing your head down. Don't
oh my gosh.
The rest of your body will follow.
I don't like this flying. I like it being inverted. I'm used to it. I'm used to it being inverted.
Put a flap orb out in front of you. Collect the orb and your wings will flap to gain speed. All right, now try flapping those wings on your own. Do a flap on your way to the next island.
What? Oh.
Ooh.
Wait a second!
Go up! Go up!
Running out
go
of
up!
Need the rest of wings.
Go up!
Still alive. Hey, I'm still standing.
Slow you down and eventually cause you to stall. And trust me, stalling sucks. You can flap while gliding to gain additional speed. So the faster you're going, the higher you can fly. Now try to reach the island up there. All right, time to take the training wheels off for the final lesson. Flying takes stamina. If you run out in midair, you are going to drop.
I just ran into fire.
A stupid, stupid. Let's get you back to the old tour building. I want to run through all the stuff you can do to hurt Satan.
Sure thing. See you soon.
Hey, easy tutorial.
Here's the deal. If you want some face time with Satan, you need to get his attention. Now, Satan hates being challenged. To undermine his control is good. Fraud, mayhem, shooting demons in the face.
Oh my
anything.
Shit. Side
you
stuff.
Can keep track of Satan's wrath with this handy meter. Get it high enough and you'll be having drinks with Big Red in no time. I've compiled a list of shit to do, so take a look and do whatever sounds fun. Oh, one more thing. We have some potential allies down here. Trust me, you want to impress them.
Was that Vlad the Impaler?
Man, you stupid!
Alright, we got our super spirit. We got our powers now, basically from Saints Row 4. Hey, they definitely reused a lot of content. Hey, but look at the map. Look at the map. It's Hell. Come on. Come on, guys. Let's all be happy. Smile.
Shut the f-
Alright, go to the quest. Oh my gosh, there's 51 quests.
Damn!
Holy hello. Select charge halo. Collect the summons power. Oh, I remember this. Okay. And look at all these little orbs all over the map. I'm pretty sure collecting all these gets you achievement.
I hope there's not something ridiculous like 100 of these to find.
Yeah.
Fucking collectible.
I actually might play this. I'm gonna play this in my free time. Hey, what's up, Blackbeard? I actually don't like this ability thing. About it.
Abandoned ship. We've been boarded.
I got your back, baby, bro.
Yeah.
All right, let's go.
Things off my ship.
I wonder what type of. Okay, I can just run into him. Oh, I need a better gun. Bro, did you just? I will kick you in your throat.
Get off him! Get off my friend!
Bro, these things are so fast.
I got a bit of treasure in that chest over there.
Get the God's hammer.
What you find inside may help with our little imp problem.
God's hammer? Oh, that don't look like God. Hey, come here. Hey, come. Hey, where are you little? What'd you say to me, you little? Hey, come over here. Come over quick. Hey, what you doing? How that taste? There we go.
Serve is my crew. I forgot what a handful they could be. Once aboard, they wouldn't listen to their captain. They ran amok in the bowels of the ship.
It's okay, man. I'm here now. They're dead. Oh, there's more? Come get this. Yeah!
Get off, Irving. No, hey, it's okay to drop the
pirate. There we go.
What pirate voice would that be?
Wow.
This voice, man, 100%. He's real deal.
Zinyak's destruction of Earth had a...
Bro, why do I like this so much?
To heaven, it was a logistical nightmare. St. Peter's meticulous nature drove purgatory wait times to unbearable levels. Meanwhile, in hell, where souls in pain were used as currency, it created a new era of prosperity for the wickedly enterprising. This economic boom resulted in the coffers of hell to be overflowing, which in turn piqued the interest of the most notorious man that sailed the seven seas. Long had Blackbeard been a thorn in Satan's side, robbing tax collectors on a semi-regular basis. But the promise of an immeasurable fortune drove him to be even bolder. An arrangement was reached. Blackbeard would provide information on strategic targets in exchange for a share of the profit. Johnny, who was interested in murder, not money, happily agreed.
Like, it's so goofy.
Grant ye the ability to summon my crew whenever they're needed.
All right, we unlocked the whole bunch now.
If I had a first mate like you when I was alive, the whole world would have shuddered.
Hey, man, thank you for everything. We're going to get on to the next stuff.
I raided a Centerpol office. Found information on where the president is being kept. Evidently, they've been trapped in some sort of soul crystal inside Satan's palace. Breaking in is an impossibility.
Oh.
Your best bet to save them is to continue to try to draw.
Why don't I remember that? I do not remember being in a soul crystal. Wait, how do I? Oh, that's how I do that. What's up, little dude? Aw, you're so cute. And what you guys doing over here? Walking the streets all by yourself? Square up. Hey, Imp, get him. Yep, get him.
Steiner souls.
Oh my God. Hold up, bro. Can I do this? Wait a second. Move. Oh my. Ah. Come here. Come catch this. Boom. You don't want it. I hand it out like Chex Mix. I don't know what that meant. I wanted it to sound cool, but...
I'm a Mega Mug.
Hey, bro. Oh, I forgot his vending machines in this one. Let me upgrade. Oh, wait. Can they not hurt me while I'm in here? I swear they could hurt me while I was in here. I can get explosive ammo already? Okay. Hey, I'm broke, but guess what? I got explosive bullets. I'm about to play patty cake with your body. Boop. All right, bro, let me stop playing around. Hey, Shakespeare, I don't know why I called you Vlad the Impaler. I'm sorry. There's a lot of old people.
Lights up. William Shakespeare, humanity's greatest playwright and hell's most diabolical purveyor of entertainment, looks on as a brave mortal on an Orphean quest enters.
Hey, bro, what you yapping, bro?
His interest is piqued, and he looks to test his visitor's mettle.
Bro, stop. Bro, that mic drop was not clean, bro. I'm killing all your friends.
The masked tragedies were used to enemies cowering.
Hey, demons, get them.
But soon they realized.
I got explosive bullets. I am not scared.
With courage and nobility.
Traits and I got a demon that eats people.
Fires of perdition.
Oh, you think that sniper's gonna do something? Ugh. What the heck? Oh, I forgot they teleport, right?
The inciting incident resolved. The time had come.
Demons, get them.
Action.
Guys, if you guys can stop shooting me.
The battle raged on below, and as bullets and blood flew, the bard arched a curious eyebrow. Could this mortal be the exact thing that Shakespeare needed?
Raise the darkness, mortal.
What is this? They're dead.
This battle is far from over, mortal. Arise.
Well, you're not cool, big bro.
No!
I didn't shoot this dude, right? I don't remember. Oh yeah, I can just shoot him. Hey bro, you better get your shield back. Hey bro, you better. Yep, you're dead. You're done. Hey, come here.
Oh my gosh!
The conflict resolved. Shakespeare eagerly awaited meeting the champion that dispatched so many of his men.
I don't care!
Undoubtedly, they were here for the bard's end.
Send more!
And while the endings were not a thing found in hell, Shakespeare always had a soft spot for comedies.
In the land of the living, William Shakespeare is regarded as one of the most prolific playwrights of all time. However, to the denizens of hell, the bard is seen in a far different light. After selling his soul for fame and adoration, Shakespeare served in hell as Satan's spy master general. In doing his duty,
it's canon.
Shakespeare would punish the souls he was investigating by forcing them to perform in grotesque passion plays for Satan's amusement. But in a Twelfth Night-esque twist, Shakespeare found himself living a double life. While he projected an image of cruelty, his heart was as soft as Jezebel's. In secret, he would tutor her on the classics and act out the works of his mortal days. When Satan found out, he cast Shakespeare out of the palace, believing that the poet would be tormented by the populace of hell, far out of Jezebel's sight. But Satan had not counted on the bard's cunning. Embracing his persona of master torturer, Shakespeare and his followers, the tragedies, took root in the entertainment district, biding their time for revenge.
So Shakespeare called forth the Deus Ex Machina to bestow our protagonist with the arcane power of force.
Boy, stop. I remember spamming this. I don't need your tutorials. I don't need your tutorials. Diversion, revenge, find and kill Dex again and again.
Make him pay for what he did to the Saints in Stillwater.
Oh! Hey, what you doing? Hey, you in my hood, what you doing? Get out of here. I'm pretty sure I would jump up super high. Hold up, look at those people over there. They look all happy, right? Ah! Oh my gosh. I'm gonna leave it there though. If you like the video, please do hit the like button. I love most games, I don't know. I'm a gamer with low standards, I guess. I don't know, I just like games. Don't be mad at me for being happy. How about you be mad at yourself for not being happy? Hey bro, but you have a lovely day. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram, like the video, subscribe, share it to your friend, do whatever you want to. Just make sure you're happy. Peace out.